So, this is it. The very, very last Home Alone fanfic sequel. This was a hell of a journey. It was a hell time getting through this whole series, but I handled it like a champ. Hey everyone, it's Movie Lover Warren 20 here, and I am here with episode 7 of my Christmas movie reviews, and this episode is going to be for none other than the fifth installment, third unnecessarily sequel in the Home Alone series, and that is Home Alone The Holiday Heist, aka Home Alone 5. And this one was released in November to TV, again, in November 2012. Yeah, we had yet another TV sequel. It aired on ABC Family in November 2012. And like all the other Home Alone sequels after 2, it was hated. Rightfully so. But anyway, let's get on with the plot of this movie. Well, the plot of this movie. Finn Baxter and his family move from California to Maine to their new house. Finn is terrified and believes the house is haunted because he plays too much video games, while he sets up traps to catch the ghost. His parents get stranded across town, and Finn is home alone with his sister. Their house is targeted by 3 thieves. That's the plot of the movie. Well, what can I say? This movie will not be as nearly insufferable as the last one I did yesterday. It is the second worst of the series. I cannot believe they were even willing to do this after the failure of taking back the house. Then again, Home Alone is a franchise that will just not die. No matter how many times you shoot at it, it's like a virus or a zombie. It just keeps coming back with another imposter clone. Like the last one, this is also a made-for-TV movie, and is not Home Alone at all, because Finn is literally with his sister the whole time, and it still looks cheaply made. And here is why I also hate this one so much with all these really bad qualities. The bad qualities, well, it does not have anything to improve over the last 2 installments that were Home Alone 3 and Home Alone Taking Back the House. The film has many of the same problems, if not repeated, from Home Alone 3. And these ones are, for example, like the third movie, Kevin doesn't appear at all or is even mentioned in this one. Not even Alex, the protagonist of the third movie, is mentioned as well. The villains are very weak. The story and villains' motivation are very ridiculous. 2. Because basically they only want to get in the house so they can rob a painting. Yeah. Instead of robbing valuables, they just want to steal a painting and leave. Yeah, the 3 of them. It's also pretty much cheap. What's worse is this movie is literally just a cheap remake of the original movie. More than a sequel. In a literal way. So yeah, it's basically a made-for-TV remake of Home Alone. And it has barely anything in common with any of the previous movies. Like, at all. The dialogue even just sometimes just makes no sense whatsoever. Some very poor acting from pretty much any of the actors. Most of the actors, anyway. Because, once again, we got a bunch of actors whose careers are nowhere, like Taking Back the House. And most of these actors, except for 1 or 2, could not act their way. Also out of a paper box. Some bland product placements, such as the Xbox 360 as well, and most of the movie doesn't even feel like a sequel at all. Instead, it feels like another generic Disney Channel movie or a pilot episode for a TV series. Well, Speaking of that, it actually, this movie aired on ABC Channel when it was first released. So that's kind of Disney and kind of away. The traps are even very boring because they are rehashing the previous films, and the new traps are just stupid. Like the trap where the leader gets scared by ghosts. Or how about this, most of the trap, there's even a window trap where the female robber, I'll get to her in a bit, gets trapped in this window, halfway in the window, and the two other robbers are trying to pull her out through the window, free her, and pulling on her legs, and Finn, the kid in this movie, shoots, like, has a slingshot, and shoots these, like, marbles, I think, at her butt. Yeah. So it makes her think that the two robbers are smacking her bum. How hilarious. Wow. And speaking of the thieves, the thieves don't even have any chemistry between each other. None of them do. And as for the two thieves, the other two thieves, we have this one. One of them's, of course, this African guy or something that seems to look like some rapper. And literally, he seems to really like eating gingerbread cookies. And he clearly believes in ghost weights much. And then the other is this, and the main leader is an old guy who I'm going to get to in a bit. By the way, now let's get on to Finn. Finn is this very unlikable protagonist when comparing to Kevin or even Alex. Even Alex was likable, a little bit. Kevin was actually likable, depending on, the Macaulay Culkin version of Kevin, not that shit Taking Back the House version of him. No. He does almost nothing but play video games, but he does get slightly better later on. And now back to the villains. The villains are generic. The leader's just some evil version of Old Man Marley, who's very stereotypical. And the black guy who I've mentioned doesn't have much of a personality and strangely looks a lot like Snoop Dogg. And the girl's just a rehash of Alice, the one I talked about with the window trap. One of the burglars from the third movie, but much more clueless and dumber. And the ending is a rehash of the third movie's ending, where the villains get mugshots, except this time none of them smile, unlike in Home Alone 3, where one of them smiled while getting his mugshot. And Finn's mother is even more neglectful to him, especially compared to Kevin's mom from the first two films and even Taking Back the House. Some scenes even rehash the first one, which makes this movie feel more like a parody. Despite the title, Finn is never even left alone at home. Like I said before, the Home Alone title was slapped on this one to make money from fans of the first two films. Because he's literally with his older sister, similar to Kevin, or fake Kevin as I call him, never being alone at all in Home Alone 4, because in Home Alone 4, there was staff at that whole house. Finn's older sister, I forget whatever the hell her name is, but she's also unlikable, and she's probably the most annoying character in this. Finn and his sister are always even on their technology the whole movie, and it's so boring and unbearable to watch them do little interesting things. So yeah. However, the reason why I don't give it the same score as Taking Back the House are because there are some redeeming qualities I have of this film. In kind of a way. Not a lot, but some. Such as, well, I guess the redeeming qualities are there is a decent remix of the Home Alone theme. But it's not a really good remix. And there are a few scenes that can be considered amusing. And the ending is a little bit heartwarming, despite the final part rehashing the third movie. And like I said before about Finn, he does get slightly better at the end. And I will say this. Malcolm McDowell does give a decent performance as the main leading robber in this. But feel bad for poor McDowell, man. Like, Malcolm McDowell is a pretty phenomenal actor. But he always gets put in shitty movies nowadays. Often you'll mostly see him in a shitty Rob Zombie movie, like the Halloween remakes or 31. You'll see him in this movie. You'll just see him in like any bad movie nowadays. It really sucks. Alice from Clockwork Orange deserves better roles. But overall, so yeah, this movie is definitely absolute horseshit and is better off not being seen if you love the first two films. And if you have seen 3 and 4, and most obviously hated them like I did, you'll definitely hate this movie too. So please, definitely skip Dislike the Plague, and here's how I will rank it.
I am going to give Home Alone The Holiday Heist a 1.5 out of 10.
And that's it for my rants on Home Alone 5, and that's it for episode 7, my Christmas movie reviews, season 2. And at least we are finally done this goddamn series. No, I'm not reviewing Home Sweet Home Alone, so we're done. We're done the series. That's the end of it. Man, honestly, I don't know. Alright, so next episode, we're going to be going back into Christmas specials. And this next episode is going to be for none other than, yeah, Christmas special, but a 2D animated one. No, it's not from Rankin Bass. It's one from Matt Groening, a.k.a. the creator of The Simpsons and Futurama. It doesn't really seem to get talked about very much. I remember this one from when I was a kid. Yeah, it was from 1999, and it's about a Jack Russell Terrier dog named Olive who saved Christmas. Yes, guys. If you're thinking I'm talking about all the other reindeer, yes, I am. That'll be the next episode of the Christmas Movie Review Season 2. Until then, that'll be it for this episode. Thank y'all for watching. If you like this and want to see more, then don't forget to like, subscribe to Movie Lover 120.